Let's start off this news conference with some really great news. Deputy Valerie Schwab has been released from the hospital. She's on her way home right now as we speak, so that's excellent news that we have pertaining to her injuries that she sustained this morning. Pertaining to this morning, just after 7:30 this morning, the Morton County 911 dispatch was alerted to an individual, a third-party caller, that had received a social media of concern to that third-party caller of one of his friends, that he was possibly going to do harm to himself. They, of course, alerted the Morton County Sheriff's Office to do a welfare check on that individual, check their status. Deputies arrived at the residence. Deputy approached the front door to make contact, and Deputy Mallory Schwab was walking around the perimeter to check the outside of the residence when a shot rang out and struck her. Deputies immediately responded to her, rendering first aid and getting her out of harm's way, taking her to a place of distance and safety, and then secured the perimeter on the inside of the residence, outside of the residence, to make sure that nobody came out and no other harm was done. The Morton County SWAT team was alerted, along with Johnson County SWAT team came in. Of course, law enforcement from throughout the county, throughout the state, our friends at ISP, Morton County Sheriff's Office, Mooresville, Martinsville, anybody was available, of course, started showing up. Deputy Mallory was, our Deputy Schwab was transported to Memphis Hospital, again, where she was treated and is luckily on her way home now. She did sustain a bullet wound to her upper right shoulder that went clean through the shoulder. No bullet was left in there. The Morton County SWAT team went to attempt to make contact with the individual inside the house. No contact was ever made with anybody inside the house. And ultimately, entrance was gained into the residence and found a male deceased inside the residence. Right now, we have turned the investigation over to the Indiana State Police. They're going to be conducting the rest of this investigation here, so be glad to answer any questions I can on my part, or I'll let you talk to Sergeant Getz here from ISP.
Sheriff, how many shots did the deputies here, do you think, were fired this morning?
That's unknown right now. ISP will be working on that part to find out for sure, but that's part of the investigation that they're working on right now, Russ.
How old was the boy? It was male?
It was a male, and I think 15
years old. 15 years old.
Was it a self-inflicted gunshot wound, how he died?
Again, we're just now starting on that to do that investigation right now. It was probably, the scene was cleared probably within the last 2 hours, so it's going to be a while yet before we'll be able to tell you what was known right there.
Can you describe for us the process that negotiators went through, not only with their attempts that were fruitless to reach out and contact, but also non-lethal attempts to bring the individual out?
They tried the cell phone, no contact there. I believe they also tried to throw a phone to get inside there. Gas, non-lethal gas, was inserted into the residence with no response. And then the actual physical, our robot was introduced into there also, and also a drone. So there was many attempts to contact and to be seen while inside the house.
Can you also describe for us the original outreach this morning to the friend on social media, and I imagine including your answer would be the appreciation that somebody was concerned enough to then make a second phone call to 911 saying, look, I got my friend.
Absolutely. That's what we want done. And unfortunately, this went the wrong way, but that's what we're here for, is check on people's individual status and to make sure they're going to be okay. The actual post, I'm not sure what it was. I was just told that it was a concerning post that they had posted and that the deputies went to check on him and make sure he was all right. But again, that's what we're here to do. That's what we do many times a day, many times a week, is check on people's welfare. And ultimately, unfortunately, this did not go the way we wanted.
Yeah, how difficult is it to have a teenager in crisis and, you know, your officers, your deputies go to try and help, and then the end result, unfortunately, is that teen's life lost, and a deputy injured.
Yeah, and there's many questions that we don't know, unfortunately, what the past was there, and hopefully through this investigation with the ISP, we may be able to learn something on that. But you don't know what people's lives are going through every day. Your life, my life, everybody's life that we encounter, or what they're going through. So unfortunately, you're kind of given a task and a detail to that you're already behind the eight ball because somebody is calling out for help and they're in distress. And we're there to help, but have a young man do this is distressful for everybody involved, for the officers.
One of the neighbors lamented to us, he said, in his words, that it's unfortunate that a youth having a very stressful day had access to a gun. Can you respond to that?
I don't know where the gun came from or how he accessed the gun. Obviously, if it was a self-inflicted gunshot wound that he ended his life with, that is terrible in itself. But I can't address how the person died.
Where so did your deputies return fire once he fired from the house?
No, there was no shots fired from our side.
Where was he found in the house?
And I don't know that either.
At this time in the course of our investigation, the scene hasn't been cleared. Investigatory phase has been started once the barricaded situation had found its resolution. Detectives from the Bloomington Post then initiated their investigation. What I can tell you is he was found in a bedroom. Again,
first floor or second floor?
I'm not sure. It is a bedroom. Our investigators are still on scene now. We are obviously very grateful that the Morgan County deputy did not sustain any life-threatening injuries or wounds. But I do want to remind the community of Morgan County, there's a family in mourning. And we, as law enforcement community, extend our deepest condolences to that family who's mourning the loss of a 15-year-old son. But it is incumbent upon us. The sheriff has asked the Indiana State Police for us to conduct this investigation and to be fully transparent with it. We just want to go make sure that we do our utmost in seeking a resolution to this investigation.
Sheriff, can you tell us if your deputies have ever been called to that address before?
I don't believe so. I can't say that for certain rest, but I don't think so. I haven't heard that per se today.
What was your message when you found out Deputy Schwab was being released from the hospital? Hey, what was your message to her?
I was ecstatic. I've been up with her most of the day today up there at Methodist, and she's in great spirits. Her family's been around her. There's been law enforcement coming in and out all day, giving her support, talking to her, EMS, fire, all been with her. The Schwab family is very ingrained in the community here in Morgan County, so she's well-known, been here all her life, worked here all her life, played sports here. She was a veteran of the Martinsville Police Department before joining us here in January, so... very well-liked person, very good police officer, very good deputy. We're proud to have her with us and proud to support the Schwab family in this time. Just looking forward to having her back.
What did she say to you?
When she was released or up there?
Well, while you were talking to her this morning.
Well, initially she kind of cussed me out because I reached in the ambulance this morning near us to give her a hug and a kiss when she was getting ready to leave. And she said a few choice letter words to me. I said, "Sheriff, don't touch her. That hurts a lot." So I knew she was going to be okay, and we had a good cry moment and got her on her way. But up there, she again, after she got up there and was talking to her family and the support, she was grateful for everybody being there and her support and just overwhelmed by the people that were coming in and out to her and what they were doing for her. And the hospital staff up there, IMPD, ISP, Martinsville, this whole community has shown up in mass and just not said where it's not what can we do, it's when and where do you need it.
Now, obviously this is a nightmare scenario for you as a sheriff. What are your thoughts around how your deputies and the other deputies on scene responded to their fellow law enforcement officer getting shot, getting her out of there in a quick manner, and then securing the scene?
Oh, I had no I knew that was going to happen. Anything that happens in this community, we're going to respond that way. Absolutely. All this whole county and this state is law enforcement proud. And I knew that we would have tons of law enforcement up there and fire and EMS to do what they could do. And it was just as I thought it would be. Anytime that we're in a crisis, we'll just reach in and pick each other up and go.
I'm assuming she was wearing a vest, but the shot evaded the vest.
That is correct, yes. Yeah, it was just right up here above it, not where the epaulet was.
And where exactly was she? So they were knocking on the door, nobody answered, and then she was just kind of walking the perimeter, seeing if she could, do you know exactly where she was?
Yeah, that's what I understand, was to the deputy, one of the deputies was knocking on the door, and she was kind of to, I'm thinking this, to the right of the deputy walking around the perimeter, and the shot rang out.
Like through a window, or?
I'm not exactly sure where it did come out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any idea how long she'll be off work?
That's up to her. No. She's got to go see an ortho later on this week to check on her if there's any bone or anything that's fractured or what the bullet did, anything through there. So she has a appointment later on this week. She's extremely sore right now, as you can imagine. So it's going to be a little bit before she'll be coming back. But she's anxious to come back. She's very willing and looking forward to it. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you coming down so much. Thank you for being here. I appreciate all the media.
Is there any body camera video or anything that your investigators are looking at that we might get access to at some point?
We do have body camera. That's going to be up to these guys since they're doing the
Certainly, we're going to be looking at every angle of this investigation, and that includes body camera footage. Obviously, once the investigation is complete, as with any investigation, death investigation, anything, we'll be submitting paperwork to the prosecutor's office for review.
And should I assume we're then awaiting word from the coroner on manner of death and identification?
Yes.
And our timetable on that might be?
I'm not sure. I know the coroner has been contacted. Again, the Indiana State Police, as of right now, they're still processing the scene. The reason for the lengthy time with this is during the barricaded situation, gas was deployed into the home, so our investigators need to kind of let that breathe, so to speak, and then they'll be able to go in there and conduct their investigation.
Thank you.